Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for September the 8th of 2019, well, it's actually a video titled Perijove 11, Passing Jupiter. So what do we see here? Well, this is a compilation of a set of images taken by the Juno spacecraft. Now, the Juno spacecraft is currently in orbit around Jupiter and is in what we call a polar orbit, so that it is orbiting around the poles of the planet instead of around its equator, as most spacecraft have a tendency to do. And it is also in a very elliptical orbit, meaning that it jumps in and comes in very close to the planet and then spends a lot of its time much further away. And it does that because Jupiter has very intense radiation belts. So in order to protect the spacecraft, it spends a limited amount of time close to Jupiter, gathering a lot of data, and then a lot of time further away, well outside of the radiation belts. So as we play the video and watch this, and this will run about a minute, we can see that there's a small piece of Jupiter that starts to appear in the lower left. And this is while the spacecraft is still a little further away, and we're seeing the polar regions with the bluer color. And then as we come in closer, we start to see great storms, so swirling storms within the atmosphere of the planet. Now we're coming in closer to the equatorial regions and starting to see the alternating light and dark bands as we reach our closest approach, and then start to recede. And we can see again within it all the turbulence within the atmosphere. So great swirls and eddies within the atmosphere as we begin to head out again away from the planet after having made its closest approach. And we'll come back up over the other polar region. And again, you can see how the kind of everything kind of circles around it. Lots of storms and turbulence within it. Jupiter has a very, very complex atmosphere. And Juno is helping us to be able to better understand that atmosphere and to learn more about the giant planet. It has been orbiting there for a number of years now. In fact, this is not its most recent passage. This is actually from early 2018. And it passes this close about once every 2 months. It'll pass in close. So it's a very long orbit, and spends a very small amount of that time very close to the planet, but does get incredibly close to the cloud tops, only about 3,500 kilometers away from the cloud tops when we get down to our closest approach. So it is giving us some of our best views of Jupiter, and Juno's mission has been extended. It's actually holding up better to the radiation than had originally been expected, and has been extended a couple of times now. And in fact, Juno has been there for over 3 years now, studying Jupiter in this orbit, and its mission has now been extended until 2021, based on current trends as to how it's working there and how it's holding up to the intense conditions and the intense radiation when it does come in close to the planet. So we should, over the coming years, get a number more of images like the ones that were used to put together the video today and to help us better understand the giant planet. So that was our picture of the day for September the 8th of 2019. It was titled Perijove 11, Passing Jupiter. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Galaxy Andromeda. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.